What's going on, guys? Downflame HD here, and welcome to the 14th episode of the FIFA 17 Sunderland Career Mode. In the last episode, we won 2-0 against Liverpool. Balde Keita and Nietzsche be getting those goals. 3-0 win against Manchester United in the FA Cup. Armstrong, Rashford and Bahrain getting those. And a 2-0 win against Rochdale in the AFL Cup semi-final first leg. Defoe and Kone getting those. Just as a side note, Jermaine Defoe is continuing to decline. A recommendation of a left mid or a striker is recommended. In the last episode, I think we were going for Marco Piaca, the 21-year-old Argentinian, I think he's Argentinian, or he might be Bosnian, left winger from Juventus. £8 million value. We bid £5 million plus to four, waiting on a contract offer, so we're trying to nail him down as a permanent signing. Once that's happened, we can take Defoe out the first team and put Armstrong in. And then we can move Barini up front in the second team and put Piaka in on the bench, as Piaka will go straight into the first team. So we're going to just jump into any transfers or anything now. We also signed Kylian Mbappe from AS Monaco on a two-year loan with a future fee of £3 million, so that's happened. We are also still top of the Premier League table, 21 points clear as of last episode. 21 points clear of second place Chelsea. And our next game is Stoke City, who are currently third in the Premier League, and it's at home. So we're just going to jump straight into that now, and let's go for more 3 points. And as the first team is tired, guys, we will go with the second team. As you can see on the screen right now, it looks like Denai has gone up and McNair's gone up, which is all good. I think everyone's gone up, actually, looking at these, apart from Billy Jones. Billy Jones is just 74, he's just shit. But yeah, that happened. So yeah, we're going to just jump into straight into this game against Stoke City with the second team, still on legendary, still unbeaten. If we score 9 goals this episode, that'll take us up to 100, so I'm really looking to get as many goals as I can. Stoke in the blue kit, let's jump in now and let's get those 3 points. Alright guys, kick off against Stoke, let's get into the game. Shout out to Rebecca Nash, who give me a lift home from work today, so she got me home in time to get this video recorded. Thank you very much, Becky. Oh, Rashford, get your ball in the middle. Terrible. Billy Jones is following it up. Duncan Watmore. Duncan Watmore, come on, pass the ball. Ryan Shawcross starts. Get foot in. Looking shaky in recent games. Marko Arnautovic plays with Jadon Sakiri in the wide positions. Stoke are having quite a bit of possession, not going to lie. So for the home don't team, like this. The chance for being a good piece of intercepting there, actually. Barini down his left-hand side, up against Glenn Johnson. He's away from Glenn Johnson. Ndong's got him in support. He's found Ndong. Ndong with the shot, but it's blocked. It's a corner. Right, Rodwell to swing it in. It's up towards Rashford. Bolster loose. And it's comfortably headed by... it's off like shit. Oh, that was a good header by Bonnie, to be honest. Afflai's still going. Jones puts it out for a corner. It's not the best start. I mean, I haven't really played FIFA that much this season. In the past week or so. So, yeah, that happened. Also, Sunderland relegated. Also, end of Premier League season as we know it. Manchester United recently won. No! Oh, fuck off, Afflai. Manchester United recently won the Europa League, so well done to them for that. Not much else to really talk about in real life football, apart from Bernardo Silva joining Manchester City. Me, personally, I don't think he should have joined Manchester City. I think he just should have probably stayed at Monaco. 22-year-old Portuguese right mid, or right winger. So, yeah, if that's what he wants to do in terms of a career move, then that's what he wants to do, but me personally, I would have just stayed at Monaco. I really would have. It's lined up for Jack Rodwell. Fucking hell, Rodwell, please. You've got to put a better shot in that. Barini. Into Rashford. Armstrong. Good first time ball back out to Rashford. Armstrong and Age in the middle. Barini. Rodwell! Why did you side foot?
Oh, you fucking meld.
Denier.
There's some potential in this.
Ndong. Someone go in the middle.
No!
Oh, for fucking crying out loud. Win that, Denier.
That's neatly done. Challenged by the defender. Very good control, though.
We've got 8 minutes to go, goal. I suppose that's a fucking free kick as well.
You need to fucking stop licking arse, you brown-nosed little prick.
Rolling the arse for Natasha. But who cares?
Get. Quite a dangerous position
now. Oh, I'm losing my temper so fucking much. Oh, I swear to God, if they score. Oh, I'm going to be so pissed.
Stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging.
That, what a load of fucking shite that game was. What a fucking pile of shite. A fucking nil-nil fucking draw. As if I've actually drew that fucking game. As if I fucking drew it.
Alright guys, and we have a transfer offer for John Armstrong. Manchester United have come in for £47.5 million. The chief executive has turned around and said his market value should be between 62 and 78. So if you send a counter offer, they might go for it. I'm rejecting all offers and disallowing future offers because this is one player I'm keeping regardless. The next transfer offer is for Fabio Barini, Valencia, with £11.5 million. Oh, I'll look at that in a second. But yeah, £11.5 million for Fabio Barini. Give me 25 and you can have him. See what they say about that. And Paris Saint-Germain have come back. I think it was like 40 million our counter offer before. They've said 30, so reject. You're not getting him. Alright guys, and we have a transfer completion or confirmation from Marco Piaga. He's finally decided to turn around and accept our offer. 5 million plus Jermaine Defoe is really good, so I'm going to go ahead and accept that now. Piaga, welcome to the team. And there we have it guys, we have Marco Piaga on a, I think it was 5-year deal. Croatian, so he's not Argentinian. Don't know where I got Argentinian from. But there we have it. He's finally signed. 77 rated. He's got quite a few good stats. I'm just looking down the right-hand side here. Quite a good few stats indeed. So we are going to put him in at the first team now. We'll do that while I'm chatting shit. So if I take Balde... Actually, he was 77 rated. So what I'm going to do is... I'll actually keep... What's his name? The big man. Keita on the bench. Keita in the first team, sorry. I'm just working this out. And then... Piaka... can go there. So where the fuck's Keita? Keita! There he's there. Yeah, just checking Mbappe there. So there we have it, guys. That's our new second team. We've moved Barini up to striker, and we've moved Piaka into the left mid spot. Hopefully, you know, something comes of it. I've never played with Piaka before, but I've heard he's got some really good talent. Looking forward to using him. Let's continue. And Valencia have come back to us. They're not willing to pay the $25 million. I was kind of hoping they would, but they're not. They've come back with a counter offer of 16.5, so I'm going to reject that. Barini is 25, he still has a few years on him yet. So we're going to hold on to him. And just as a quick update, Piaka now has the number 18 shirt that Jermaine Defoe left. Defoe was our top goal scorer with 20 goals, so that still counts for me as part of the series anyway. So we'll see who the top goal scorer is at the end of the season. So let's move on to the next game. All right, guys, and I've just had a little brainwave. DeAndre Yedlin is a right back that I've used quite a bit in my years of FIFA, and to be quite honest, I'm looking at him to replace Billy Jones when we find him. Billy Jones is worth 2.1 million, and I know that DeAndre Yedlin isn't worth that much. So I'm going to go ahead and try a straight swap with Jones and see what happens with that, because, yeah. I mean, he's pacey, he's got stamina, and he'll grow as a player. So we'll see what happens with Yedlin, and I'll keep you guys updated. Alright guys, second game of the episode, we're going with the first team. Newly promoted John Armstrong is up front alongside Nichibi. We have Piaka on the bench, we also have Mbappe on the bench as well. So we're going to bring them on at half time and see how well they do against West Brom. We're going to jump into the game now, let's go for the 3 points because we dropped two in the last game. Kirchhoff, I'm hoping that the Stoke game is a one-off. And Nichibi, Kirchhoff, into Armstrong. Armstrong, 1-0. It's that easy. It's... I was, like I said, I hope the Stoke game's a one-off and we go and score. 3 minutes into the game, Armstrong links well with Nichibi and Kirchhoff there. Good little pass there by Kirchhoff into Armstrong. Armstrong slots it away like a pro. Just as well we kept hold of him, it's 1-0. You have to be at the top of your game to try and to convert. Armstrong. Oh, what passage of play is this? Ball to Ikeda. Falls back to Yanezai. Yanezai with a scoop turn. Falls to Nichibi. Falls to Nichibi again. It's... Oh, yes. I love that. That was excellent play down the left-hand side. We managed to get the shot off. But it was very good determination there by Nichibi for him to get the shot off originally. And then Lady Luck kind of shined on us when the ball sort of landed back at each of his feet. But even so, it's 2-0, and it definitely looks like 3 points around the cards. And exactly like I said, guys, two substitutions at half time. Keita comes off, and Piaka comes on, and Anichibi comes off for Mbappe. So let's get into the second half, and let's see how these two play. And there we have it, guys. It's 2-0 win against West Brom at the Hawthorns. I'm happy with this, kind of, a little bit. Piaka and Mbappe didn't really do much in that second half. Piaka got on the ball down the left-hand side. Good few crosses, but nothing come of them, so the problems won't be in the highlights. And Mbappe just run around, wasted energy, really. There was no really point in bringing him on. But to be fair, it's a 2-0 win, it's 3 points. I'm not going to complain. Goals from Armstrong and Nichibi. So we're just going to jump into the last game now. And if anything develops in the way of transfers or whatever in between this game and the next game, I'll let you know as usual. Transfer offer for Marcus Rashford. £16.5 million from Schalke. We're going to go ahead and reject that because it's Rashford and we really need to keep hold of him at the moment. Next transfer offer is for Jan Kirchhoff, £11 million from Leicester City. Again, he's a first team player, Jan Kirchhoff, so we're just going to hold on to him. As for DeAndre Yedlin, we've reviewed your offer that you've made for DeAndre Yedlin. Unfortunately, we cannot go ahead with the deal because we are not interested in the player and the cash amount is not high enough. So what about $5 million? 3 million plus Jones. Fuck it. I just want rid of Billy Jones. So, Newcastle United have gotten back to us just shortly after. We've received your offer that you've made for DeAndre Yedlin. Unfortunately, we cannot go ahead with the deal. The exact same message as before. So, we'll increase it to 5. And this is going to be our last offer for Yedlin. I just don't like Jones. I really just don't like Jones. Alright, and Newcastle United have accepted our offer for DeAndre Yedlin. 5 million plus Billy Jones. So, if we... So, he's on 30 grand... Or, he wants 30 grand. I can afford that on a 4-year squad rotation. I can work with that. I can actually work with that. So, we've given him that contract, 4 years squad rotation and 30 grand a week. So, we'll see what happens with that after our next game against Rochdale. And here we have it, guys. We have Rochdale in the EFL Cup semi-final second leg. And we're 2-0 up off the first leg. So I'm hoping that if I just sim it, then we should be good. So we're gonna hit advance here, and we're gonna see what happens. And HB gets a yellow card. Okay. Come on, get a goal. Come on. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, yes, Baldi. No. Yes. No, I don't know. Shit, do we go through? I don't know what happens. We just got beat 2-1 on the ninth, but we win 3-2 on aggregate because of an away goal. I don't know. Advance. I've never simmed a game before. I've always played. I don't know what's going on. February. Yes! Southampton in the final. Come on! Yes! Alright, so we... yeah! So we're through the final of the EFL Cup because... well... that happened. So we ended up losing 2-1. But Keita got our goal, which is fine. It still counts. So... yeah, go us! Alright guys, and transfer offer for Lee Catamore now. £7 million from Nice, rejecting that because I still believe Catamore has a role to play at the club. So we are rejecting that. DeAndre Yedlin has accepted the contract. So welcome DeAndre Yedlin to the club. And here we have it guys, DeAndre Yedlin is now part of the club. I know, Newcastle player, boo hoo. But he is a very solid right back once he starts to grow, so I've put him on the bench there to signify that he's actually in the second team again as a replacement of Billy Jones. He's only one rating lower than Jones, so we've kind of got some bang for our buck there. If we quickly go into the second team and replace Manquillo with Pickford, and then Pickford with DeAndre Yedlin. So there we have it. Change, would you like to save changes to the team sheet? Yes. DeAndre Yedlin is now officially part of the club, £5 million plus Billy Jones. I haven't actually noted that down yet, and I really should. One day I will actually show you the notepad that I've got for the Cremo, so I know exactly where we're at. But if we quickly go and find DeAndre Yedlin, there he's there, and there we have it. There is his stats. He's got 93 pace, he has 87 agility. Decent tackling stats, not going to lie. 89 stamina, which is very good because he's going to be bombing up and down that wing quite a bit. Just before I end the episode, I'm going to bring up the Premier League table to show you any changes in it. So well, let's do that now. And here we have it, guys. The Premier League table. Our next game is against Oxford United in the FA Cup round 4 at the Stadium of Light. However, I wasn't able to bring up the Premier League table without going into other leagues. So I've got the Premier League table here. We're sitting comfortably top still. That looks like 19 points clear. So we have dropped 2 points, unfortunately. Played 22, won 21, drew 1. Stoke City are a cunt. Chelsea are second on 43 points. Stoke are still fucking third on 37. I don't know how, but they are. Manchester City are fourth on 34. And Spurs are fifth on 32. Moving into the relegation zone. Rock bottom are Burnley on 14, Everton are still in the relegation zone on 15 points, and Leicester are still in the relegation zone as well on 16. If Leicester leave, I may go in for Mahrez, I may go in for that young centre defensive mid that they bought in to swap for Kante, to replace Kante. Who was it? Ndidi, I think it is. So yeah, that's pretty much it as far as the Premier League table is concerned. So this has been the 14th episode of Premod. I want to thank you so very much for watching. If you're new around here, hit that subscribe button. If you liked the video and want to see some more, drop a thumbs up as well. It'd be greatly appreciated. Thank you for all the support for the series. I really am enjoying playing Career Mode. I know we simmed a game, but it still counts as a game. So yeah, through the EFL Cup final, that's Southampton on February 26th. signed three players. Well, signed two, signed one last episode. But yeah, we're doing very, very good, I reckon. So thank you so very much for watching. And I'll see you guys later.